Dear student of class 6, once again I welcome you to the online classes. So today let's open our geography book on page 9. So in the last class I have discussed about scale of map, and there are different types of scale of map. So there are three types: the statement scale, then the representative fraction scale, and the linear or graphic scale. So dear student, let us read in details. The statement scale. The statement scale is the easiest to read. It needs no calculation to read and understand what it indicates. So dear student, the statement scale is easiest to read, and it needs no calculation to read and understand what it indicates. So it uses simple words to represent the ratio of the distance on the map to that of corresponding distance on the ground. For example, the statement scale is written as 1 cm equal to 2 kilometers. You can measure on the scale that 1 cm, 1 centimeter is equal to 2 kilometers. That means 1 cm on the map. 1 cm on the map. I can show you the map. In this India political map, the scale 1 cm is equal to 42.2 kilometers. In every map, in the top, that the scale is mentioned. So this is the statement scale. And look at your book. 1 cm is equal to 2 kilometer. This means 1 cm on the map is equal to 2 kilometer on the ground. Some examples of statements are 1 cm is equal to 25 kilometers. Then 1 inch is equal to 200 miles. Then this scale has a disadvantage and cannot be used universally in all the countries. All the countries do not use the metric system or any universal unit of measurement. So here we have to understand that this statement scale cannot be used universally, or all the countries do not use the metric system or universal unit of measurement. Then let us discuss about the representative fraction scale. the representative fraction scale overcomes this disadvantage of the statement scale. Here, in the statement scale is not used universally, but the representative fraction scale, in shortly we say RF, is used universally. So the RF is means representative scale is given as a ratio of the distance on the map taken as unity to the corresponding distance on the ground where both values have the same unit and therefore no unit. Here, by using this representative fraction scale, that ratio of the distance and corresponding distance on the grounds are both values are same. That means this particular representative fraction scales are used universally. For example, 1:200 means 1:200 means 1 cm on the map is equal to 200 cm on the ground, or 1 inch is equal to 200 inches on the ground. It is very simple to understand, since it has no unit, or the representative fraction can be universally used all over the world. As I told you about the statement scale is not used universally. Any suitable unit can be placed on both sides and used to calculate the distance on the map. The representative fraction scale just says that 1 unit is equal to 200 unit. Okay, that means 1 unit is equal to 200 units. And the unit may be any. That unit may be any. The numerator or value of distance on the map is always 1. Okay. The value of distance on the map is always 1. This scale, however, needs some calculation to get an idea of what it actually represents. For example, if the representative fraction scale of a map is 1:50,000, then by definition it means, look at the book, it means 1 cm, 1 cm is equal to 50,000 cm. If we convert 50,000 cm into meters, okay, 50,000 cm into meters, we get 1 cm is equal to 50,000 is divided by 1,000 equal to 500 meters. And this 500 meters, if we will calculate in kilometers, this 500 meters become 0.5 kilometer, means half kilometer. So the statement scale of this representative fraction would read 1 cm is equal to 500 meters or 0.5 kilometer. If we convert this statement into whole numbers, we get 1 cm equal to 0.5 kilometer. Then 2 into 1 cm is equal to 2 into 0.5 kilometer. So 2 cm equal to 1 kilometer. Thus, the representative fraction scale of 1 is to 50,000 means that 2 cm on the map shows 1 kilometer on the ground. So dear student, I hope you have understood. So now let us discuss the linear scale. The linear scale is represented through the graphic drawing of the scale with division and subdivision, and is therefore also known as the graphical scale. Here we have to remember, or we have to know, that this linear scale is in other word known as graphical scale. Why? It is divided with divisions and subdivisions in the graphical drawing of the scale. Each division measures the distance on the map and the value written along the scale shows the distance on the ground. The big division on the scales are called primary divisions. What is called primary divisions? The big divisions on the scales are called the primary divisions. We have to remember. Then the zero or the beginning of the scale is marked after the first primary division. The first primary division of the scale is further divided into small divisions or secondary divisions. For example, the scale shows 1 cm is equal to 1 kilometer. The unit of the primary or secondary divisions may be the same or different, like kilometers and meters, etc. So dear student, this primary and secondary divisions may be the same or different, like the kilometers and meters. So dear student, I hope you have understood. So in the next class, we shall discuss about the direction. So dear student, try to understand and study well, and we shall meet in the next class. Thank you.